Hello, and welcome to another MariaDB screencast. Today I'll be talking about the MariaDB release process. This is based on a talk that I recently gave at the Southeast Linux Fest in Charlotte, North Carolina. You can find more about the Southeast Linux Fest at their website, southeastlinuxfest.org. So, when I say release process, what am I talking about? Well, open source projects start with code. The end products of that code are various packages, binary tarballs, RPM packages, Debian packages, and so on, something that end users can install. So how do we get from code to easily installable packages? Well, that's what this talk is about. Of course, that begs the question, why make packages at all? Why not just provide the source code and call it a day? Well, the answer is because many users either don't know how or don't have the time to compile and install the software themselves. There will always be some that don't mind doing this, but many don't want to bother with it. So in the MariaDB project, we try to provide binaries and packages for as many systems as we can. The centerpiece of our build system is BuildBot. You can find more information on BuildBot on their website. We use BuildBot for automating the MariaDB build test cycle. Basically, during development, BuildBot will watch the various BZR trees. Bazaar, or BZR, is the source code management system that we use for MariaDB. These BZR trees are on Launchpad, and they correspond to either various MariaDB versions or to a developer's personal working tree. Whenever BuildBot sees a change, it will build and test the tree. Well, how does it do this? Well, BuildBot has a client-server architecture. The server tells the clients when to build and what to build. The clients, and we have a lot of them, are a mixture of physical hosts and virtual machines. We use KVM for our virtualization, by the way, and we have a run VM wrapper script that we use to make running the VMs easier. The script is GPL licensed and available in the MariaDB tools project on Launchpad, so feel free to make use of it with your projects. So what does BuildBot do? Well, the first thing it does is create a source tarball. Then it spins up a virtual machine and uploads the tarball to it, or just copies the tarball over in the case of a real physical machine. It then builds MariaDB in whatever format that client has configured to create. It could be a binary tarball, a Windows MSI package, a set of CentOS or Fedora RPMs, or a set of Debian packages. Once the packages or binary tarballs are built, they're tested. In the case of virtual machines, different virtual machines are used to simulate installing MariaDB, upgrading from MySQL to MariaDB, and upgrading from an old version of MariaDB to the new version. The test will either pass or fail. Success and failure is logged, and if there's a failure, the developers will examine it. When they next push in new code, the whole process is repeated, from a source tarball on through to creating a package and testing it to see if all the tests pass. BuildBot has a web interface where anyone can check on the status of the most recent builds. The developers even have the ability to redo a build if there was something on the operating system of the builder that prevented a build from being successful, like a missing library or a power outage during the build. Everything BuildBot does is logged, and there's no secret sauce. For example, if you click on one of the OK or failed links on the BuildBot page, you're taken to a summary page for the build. On the summary page, you can click on, for example, the standard I/O link of the compile step, and you can see a list of every single command that was run on the BuildBot client to produce whatever that client was configured to produce. That could be a package, a tarball, whatever. For a release, in addition to all the features planned for the release, you want the release to be green in BuildBot. This column, for example, corresponds to MariaDB 5.5.24, which is one of our most recent releases. So, once BuildBot is done building the packages, we have packages and it's time to get them to where they'll be useful. I have a script which grabs the source and various tarballs and binaries and uploads them from our build machines, which are located in Finland, to the Oregon State University Open Source Lab, which is the primary MariaDB mirror. From there, the files are transferred to other mirrors around the world. So that takes care of the binaries and the Windows packages, but what about the Linux packages? Packages are not repositories. Buildbot creates packages, and to make sure that there are no mistakes, we have scripts to create the repositories. They're part of the previously mentioned MariaDB tools project on Launchpad, so feel free to check them out. They're nothing super awesome or anything, they just are used to avoid making mistakes. The scripts also handle signing the packages with our signing key, and for those of you who are interested, this is the ID of our signing key, the short form, and the full key fingerprint. Anyway, with the repositories created, I upload them, and they get mirrored just like the binary packages. So, what's next? Well, documentation. With any luck, a lot of the documentation will have already been written and uploaded to our knowledge base prior to the release. The Maria developers are pretty good about getting this done when they add new features to MariaDB, such as new options to create table or new optimizer flags. But as we near a release, it's always a good idea to check to make sure that the changes have been documented. There's also the release notes and the changelog. They're not written until very late in the development stages for a release. The release notes is just a summary of what's in the release, but the changelog is a list of every single push made between this release and the previous one. So it only gets created at the very end, right before the release happens. The raw changelog looks like this. It's directly exported from Bazaar, and it's fairly readable, but we make it more usable by formatting it with links to the tree on Launchpad, to the bug reports for the bugs that were fixed in the release, and so on. Once the documentation is in place, and the downloads are mirrored worldwide, we are finally ready to release. Well, actually announce the release. After all, if a release happens but nobody hears about it, did the release actually happen? To announce releases, we have an announce mailing list, which you can subscribe to at MariaDB.org. It's a low-traffic mailing list used just for announcements. We also post announcements to our higher-traffic discuss and developer mailing list. Oh, and we also don't want to forget to blog about the release or to post it to the various social media networks, Google+, Facebook, Twitter, and so on. Anyway, that's about it. I hope you have enjoyed this look inside the MariaDB release process. Here's some links that you may be interested. Of course, MariaDB.org, our knowledge base at kb.askmonty.org, and our Maria Discuss mailing list on Launchpad, and don't forget our various social media links. If you have any suggestions for future screencasts, please let me know in the comments below. Thank you, and hope you have a great day.